All right, welcome everybody to today's dance aerobic session. We are doing New Kids on the Block versus Boyz II Men. Let's start in our walking in place or walking in the space that we have and getting our bodies warmed up. We have the same sequence that we have had for October, so we'll go through and we do have some new folks to the sequence, so we'll break the moves down. That being said, if anyone has any questions, feel free to interrupt and ask at any point. And as always, modify any movements or take breaks, get water whenever you need. You have your own space, so it's not disruptive if you take your own little break. All right, let's move to arm circles next. Stick your arms out into a T shape. Fingertips point left and right, palms face down. Roll those shoulders forward, small circles to start. And each time you circle, make it a little bit bigger here and until you're going through your full range of motion, making them as big as you can. Loosening up the shoulders, getting the upper body involved here. When you're ready and you've gone through your full range of motion, let's reverse direction, starting small. Backward circles, getting bigger each time we go. Bringing the heat through the arms, shoulders, and
I'm
shake
feeling
at that.
it
Oh, good.
today.
Shake that all out. Let's go to glute kicks next. So bring one heel back to your bottom and then switch. Let's get our arms involved. So arms bent at an L shape or a 90-degree angle. Opposite arm swings forward as opposite heel kicks back, helping us balance. As you kick your heel back, point that bending knee down towards the ground. That increases the stretch through the front of the leg, the thigh, the quads, and increases the contraction of the hamstring, the back of your thighs. All right, we're going to trade these glute kicks out for high knees. So get your knees up nice and high, continuing to swing your arms in opposition. Going from stretching the fronts of our thighs to the backs of our legs, so our hamstrings. Getting those knees up as high as you can. Moving at your own pace, waking our bodies up. Upper and body moving together. And shake that out. Let's move to windmill toe touches. Feet go wider than shoulder width apart, toes point forward. Arms go into a T shape, just like if we were going to start arm circles. Opposite hand reaches to opposite leg or foot area by hinging at the waist, reaching down and across, then standing up nice and tall and repeating on the other side. So left hand to right foot. Come up, right hand to left foot, come up, hinging at the waist, pushing those hips back as you go down, squeezing your glutes to push those hips up as you come up. Big stretch through the backs of your legs, shoulder mobility. You're getting some core work in here as we twist, and some spine stretch, spine twist. Multi-purpose full body stretch. Nice deep breaths as we go at your own pace. And trade those out for calf raises or heel raises. Standing with your feet hip width apart, toes point forward, heels go up, heels go down. Option to hold on to something for balance or lift one heel at a time and then switch. So toes stay on the ground, heels go up. Glorious. Take this time to stretch out anything else that you need, maybe something felt tight. Spend some time on that, and I'll break down our moves for sequence one. Four moves. We have three sequences. Each sequence has its own set of four moves. I'll break them down. Feel free to ask questions, and I'll call out the changes as we do it to music. So, first sequence, we have side step and shoulder pop. So let's start with our hands by our side, feet hip width apart, toes point forward. For our side step, you are going to take your right foot, step it to the right, Then bring it back to starting position. Left foot, step it to the left, back to starting position. That's our lower body. Now let's add our upper body. When your right foot steps out, you are going to make a chicken wing with your right arm. So right hand comes towards right armpit, elbow is bent. Right foot steps out, right elbow points to the right with your chicken wing. Come back in, elbow down, switch sides. Left hand into left armpit, left foot steps out, left elbow points left, come back in. So you're doing a side step and your shoulder pop, your chicken wing at the same time, repeating every other. Any questions about side step, shoulder pop? Okay. We continue to knee bend and heel tap. So start standing in a comfortable position, toes point forward. Have a slight bend in your knees. So you keep your feet flat on the ground. Just have a nice bouncy little bend in your knees. So you're not going into a squat or anything, just a slight bend. And then when you come up out of the bend, you'll stand up straight and tap your right heel on the ground in front of you. Bring it back. Knees are bent. Stand up nice and tall. Left heel taps. So knee bends, then you tap one heel. Any questions about that one? Okay. Next up is high knee core twist. Opposite knee comes up and opposite elbow reaches towards your knee. So if my left knee comes up, my right elbow is going to reach for my left knee and then switch. Your elbow does not have to touch your knee. That's okay. Just that's the direction we're moving in. So knees go straight up and down. Your core twists to try to get your elbow over towards your opposite knee. Any questions about high knee core twist? Okay, next and last move is step cross jump. So you're gonna be traveling side to side. I'm gonna start on the left side of my space. I'm gonna take my right foot, step it out to the right. Then I'm gonna cross my left foot in front or behind my right foot. So that's the step cross. Now uncross your feet and hands in the air, jump. So it's step, cross, together, jump, step, cross, together, jump, going back and forth in your space. If you want to not do the jump, you can replace the jump with a clap, snap, hip bump, whatever you'd like. Turn it into a grapevine. Are there any questions about shoulder pop or sidestep and shoulder pop, knee bend, heel tap, high knee core twist, or step, cross, jump? Okay, then we break it down on the dance floor. Our first song is New Kids on the Block, and it's called You Got It, in parentheses, The Right Stuff. I'll call it the moves. If music is wonky, let me know if I should turn it up or down. Okay, side step and shoulder pop in 3, 2, 1. One foot steps out, other elbow and your elbow points in the same direction. Knee bend, heel tap. Both knees bend, stand up tall, tap one heel.
Tara, can you go a touch higher?
Yep. High knee core twist. How's that?
Perfect.
Okay. Yeah. Opposite elbow to opposite knee. Step cross jump. Side step and shoulder pop. Chicken wing.
Go.
Knee bend, heel tap.
Thank you.
step, cross, jump. Shoulder pop. Knee bend, heel tap. Finish it out. Nice job, everyone. All right. I'm going to get a sip of water, and I'll break down our sequence number two moves. Okay. Sequence number two is cross punches and tap. So you're going to punch both arms out to shoulder height, but you're going to do it in an X. So they're both punching at a diagonal. Bird's eye view, your arms are in an X. That's upper body. Lower body is when you punch, you're just going to tap your right toes in front of you, bring everything back down, and then tap your left toes in front of you next time you punch out. Every time I punch my arms, I alternate which arm is on top in the X. You can do that if you so choose. Any questions about cross punches and tap? Okay. Next up is side step and point. Stand in a comfortable position, toes point forward, hands by your sides. Right foot steps right, both arms point to the right. Step back in, arms down. Left foot steps to the left, both arms point left. Step back in, arms down. Any questions about side step and point? Okay, next up is diagonal heel tap. So take your left heel and tap it in front of your right foot, bring it back. Right foot, right heel taps in front of left foot, bring it back. There is no assigned upper body, but what I like to do is every time my heel taps, I push my arms back behind me like a tricep extension. And then when I set my feet together, my hands come together in front of my torso. And then I push my hands back behind my hips once again, every time I tap my heel. Any questions about diagonal heel tap? Okay. Next up, we walk it out. So four steps forward, four steps back. Add your own flavor, your own strut, your own pizzazz to your walking forward and back. Any questions about cross punches and tap, side step and point, diagonal heel tap, or walking? Okay, then we hit it. Next song is Boyz II Men. We're going every other. And we have Motown Philly. And cross punches and tap in 3, 2, 1. Punching your arms in an X at shoulder height. Opposite toe tap. Side step and point. Boyz II Men. diagonal heel tap. Tap your heel in front of your opposite foot. Walk it out. Cross punches and tap. Side step and point. Diagonal heel tap. Walk it out.
Yo, these four new jacks is real smooth on a harmony chip. Make Mike shine a one, you know the mentality. Keep flipping the gift.
Cross punches and tap. Side step and point. Diagonal heel tap. Walk it out. Cross punches and tap. Walk it out. Cross punches and tap. Finish it out. Nice job, everybody. Let's keep going. Sequence three, get some water, shake anything out. Let's keep going. All right, we have arm pumps, which are feet are apart, about shoulder width apart, toes point forward, arms by your sides. For lower body, you'll step your right foot in to meet your left, so feet are together, and then step it back to your starting position. Repeat on the left. Left foot steps into right, step it back out to starting position. Now, let's add the arm piece. So when your feet are apart, your hands are by your side. When your feet are together, your hands are up by your armpits, so that forces you to bend your elbows. Your elbows can point either out to the sides or behind you, and then arms go back down when your feet are apart. So feet together, hands to your armpits, feet apart, hands to your sides. Any questions about arm pumps? Okay, next up is lower punch. So we're gonna do a diagonal heel tap here. And then for our diagonal heel tap, we're going to add a punch with our opposite arm. So right heel taps in front of left foot, left arm punches towards right hip. This takes balance. Left heel taps in front of right foot, right arm punches down towards the left hip. That's our lower punch. Any questions about that one? Okay, then we have wide glute kicks. So we did glute kicks in the warm-up. Now you're just doing them with a wide stance, keeping that knee pointed down as you bend your heel back. Any questions about that one? Okay, then we have walk and kick. Three steps forward, kick one leg out in front of you. Three steps backward, kick your leg behind you. When I kick my leg behind me, I keep it straight. And when I kick my leg in front of me, I also keep it straight. So straight leg kick. Any questions about arm pumps, lower punch, wide glute kicks, or walk and kick? Okay. Then without further ado, song number three, back to New Kids on the Block, step by step. Let's start with arm pumps in 3, 2, 1. Feet apart, hands by your side, feet together, hands by your armpit. Lower punch. Opposite heel tap, opposite punch. Wide glute kick. And kick. Arm pump. Feet apart, arms down, feet together, arms up. Lower punch, opposite heel tap, opposite punch. Step by step. Ooh, baby. Gonna get to you, girl. Wide glute kick. Walk and kick. Arm pump. Lower punch. Step by step. Ooh, baby. Gonna get to you, girl. Wide glute kick. Walk and kick. Step by step. Step one, one, one. Arm pump.
Have lots of fun. Step two, two, two. There's so much we can do. Step three, three, three. It's just you and me. Step four, four. I can give you more.
Lower punch. Wide glute kick.
Step by step. Don't you know I need you? Step by step. Yes, I do, girl.
Walk and kick.
Step by step. Oh, baby, you're always on my mind. Step by step.
Arm pump. lower punch. Wide glute kicks. Finish it out. Fabulous. Let's keep going. We are back to sequence one. Sequence one is sidestep and shoulder pop. So feet are in together. Chicken wing arms. Right foot steps out. Right chicken wing. Left foot steps out. Left chicken wing. Then we have knee bend and heel tap, slight bend in your knees, stand up tall, one heel tap, slight bend in your knees, other heel taps. Then we have high knee core twist, opposite elbow to opposite knee. And then we have step, cross, jump, option to ditch the jump and add a move of your choice. Any questions, review, or modifications needed for any of those? Okay. Then we keep going. We have Boyz II Men back up next. And our song is One Up for Love. And we start with sidestep and shoulder pop. 3, 2, 1. Chicken dance.
When it all began, we were perfect then. Somehow we have lost our way.
Knee bend, heel tap.
We keep going there, and I know you're scared. We will make it back one day.
High knee, core foot. Step, cross, jump.
Too many are broken, and the smoke keeps rising up. You know,
tiny core twist.
With all of this confusion, everybody's losing. When's it gonna be enough? Oh, yeah. So no more fighting now.
That's cross jump. And shoulder pop.
Find a way to bring it back to love. Bring it back, bring it
no
back.
Step, cross, jump.
We can change the world.
We can change the world this time.
Side step and shoulder pop. Okay, let's keep going. I'm going to get a quick drink. We move on to sequence two. Okay, sequence two, we have cross punches and taps. So that's punching your arms out into an X from bird's eye view. Arms are at shoulder height. tapping opposite toes in front of you each time. Then we have side step and point, starting feet together, hands by your side, right foot steps right, both arms point right, left foot steps left, both arms point left. Then we have diagonal heel tap, opposite heel taps in front of opposite toes. And then we have walking it out, add your own flair. Anyone have any questions, comments, concerns, need any modifications, clarifications for any of those? Okay, then we go to back to New Kids on the Block with Hangin' Tough, and we do cross punches and tap in 3, 2, 1. Side step and point. Listen up, everybody, if you want to take a chance. Just get on the floor to the New Kids Dance. Diagonal heel tap. Because it won't take long. We're going to put you in a trance with the funky song. Walk it out. Cross punches and tap. Side step and point. Diagonal heel tap. Walk it out. Cross punches and tap. Side step and point. Diagonal heel tap. Walk it out. Cross punches and tap. Side step and point. Diagonal heel tap. Walk it out. Everybody. Cross punches and tap. Step and point. Finish it out. Nice job, everybody. Let's keep it moving and grooving along. Sequence number 3. We have arm pumps. So feet apart, hands by your side, feet together, hands at your armpits. Lower punch, opposite heel tap, opposite punch. Wide glute kicks. And then walk 3 steps forward, kick 3 steps backwards, and kick. Anyone have any questions or need any modifications for any of those? Then we continue. We're back to Boyz II Men, and we have Under Pressure, starting with arm pumps in 3, 2, 1. Lower punch, opposite punch, opposite heel tap. Wide glute kick. Walk and kick. Arm pumps. Lower punch. Wide glute kick. Walk and kick. Arm punch. Lower punch. Wide glute kick. Walk and kick. Arm pump. Lower punch. Let's finish it up. Nice job, everybody. All right. Let's take it back to the top. I'm going to get a sip of water. We go back to sequence number one, which is side step and shoulder pop, the chicken wing dance, knee bend, heel tap, high knee core twist, opposite elbow to opposite knee, and step cross jump. Does anyone have any questions or need any modifications for any of those? Okay. The dance party continues. We're back to New Kids on the Block, and our next song is Cover Girl starting with sidestep and shoulder pop in 3, 2, 1. Knee bend, heel tap. High knee core twist. That cross jump. Side step and shoulder pop. Knee bend, heel tap. High knee core twist. Side step and shoulder pop. Knee bend, heel tap. Step cross, or no, yeah, step cross jump. Side step and shoulder pop. Knee bend, heel tap. These songs today are quite long.
Yeah.
Catching my breath. High knee core twist to finish it out. Woo. Nice job, everybody. Catch your breath. We are going to move into our last song, and we have to vote. New Kids on the Block or Boyz II Men. What are people
thinking? I'm going to go with New Kids on the Block for me.
Shall we vote? Okay, two votes for New Kids on the Block. Any other
votes? New Kids on the Block.
Three votes for New Kids on the Block. Okay. Well, then we have either Tonight or Call It What You Want. Who do we want? Which one do we want? Both by New Kids on the Block.
I don't know. I've heard of either one. Tara, do you either have one. The remix? Do you have a song called The Remix?
That's I a do lighter. Not.
Okay. Well, you picked it. I have no idea.
Did anyone have a preference? Nope. Okay. We're going to play the song called Tonight. And we're going into sequence three. Arm pumps, lower punch, wide glute kicks, and walk and kick. Take this to your as your intro to cool down. Start slowing down your body. All right, arm pumps in 3, 2, 1. Lower punch. Touch about hanging tough. As long as you got the right stuff, in we go. Ooh. Wide glute kick. Well, I guess it's a brand new day after all. Every time we hear the curtain call. Walk and kick. Arm pump. Remember when we traveled around the world? We met a lot of people. And girls. Lower punch. Men met from everywhere. Showed us how you care. Didn't it, girls? Ooh. Wide glute kick. Walk and kick. Arm pump. Lower punch. Wide glute kick. Walk it out. Walk and kick. Arm pump. And finish it out. Amazing job, everyone. We're going to start our cool down now. Feel free to follow along with me or do your own cool down stretches. Take it as you need. I'm going to get a quick drink and we'll meet in cat cow on the ground. All right, for cat cow, our hands go beneath our shoulders, our knees go beneath our hips in a tabletop position. Dip your belly low, point your nose forward to stretch out your abdominals, your ab wall. And then tuck your chin to your chest, push your spine to the sky for cat, pushing weight through the palms of your hands. Go through at your own pace, stretching out the core and the spine. Maybe you add more wiggles, maybe you shift your weight forward, back. And go ahead, curl your toes under, straighten your legs, hips to the sky, upside down V shape into your pike or downward dog position. Heels come to the ground to get a deeper stretch through the backs of your legs.
Shift your hips back so your head goes between your arms for a deeper stretch through the spine. Take a couple deep breaths. And when you're ready, roll down onto the ground. Back is on the ground. Hug your right knee to your chest. Extend your left leg long on the ground, or if that's too much pressure on your lower back, plant your left foot flat on the ground. Both are fine. And switch legs. Left leg in, right leg long, or right foot planted. When you're ready, hug both knees into your chest. Arms go into a T shape on the ground at shoulder level. Let your knees fall to the right, nose points left. Only let your knees fall as far as is comfortable for you. Spine twist, shoulder opener. Bring your knees back to center. Let them fall left this time, nose points right. Go ahead and untwist. Come to a seated position. Extend your legs straight long in front of you. Reach for your toes, seated forward fold. Big stretch through the backs of your legs and your spine. And we'll end our cool down in butterfly position. The soles or the bottoms of your feet will come together in front of you, making your knees bend out to either side. Play with the distance. Your feet are away from you. Closer is more intense. Leaning forward is more intense. Sitting up nice and tall is less intense. Feet further away from you is less intense. The angle in which your knees point out to the sides, the further down they point, the more intense, the further up, the more relief. Feel free to continue your cool down, as it was a little short today. I'm going to stop our recording.